Try Guy presents The White House by Ted Arnold. Fly Guy is copyright by Ted Arnold, and it's published by Scholastic Inc. And there's a lot of photo credits in this, so I don't own any of them. A boy had a pet fly named Fly Guy. Fly Guy could say the boy's name.
Buzz.
Buzz and Fly Guy walked through the gates of the White House.
Cool,
said Buzz.
This is where the President of the United States lives and works.
Fly Guy did a loop-de-loop. He was excited. Or he just smelt some poop nearby. He zoomed ahead of Buzz and flew inside. The address of the White House is 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Oh no, now everybody's gonna know where the president lives. It is located in Washington, D.C., the capital of the United States. Hundreds of people work at the White House every day.
That's a White House meeting with President Obama.
The Secret Service, the Chief of Staff, the press secretary, speechwriters, and several advisors work with the president. You think he can do this on his own?
Well, would you look at that guy? You ever think that Secret Service agent thought he'd be famous someday? And look, it's the press secretary.
And a team of chefs, butlers, maids, florists, electricians, and plumbers keep the place running smoothly.
There's even a beekeeper.
The president is the leader of the United States and the head of our government. The president also represents our country around the world and is the leader of the armed forces.
The president's family is called the First Family. There's been a lot of first families, which actually doesn't make any sense.
The president's wife is called the First Lady. She welcomes guests to the White House for ceremonies and special events. I bet she does a lot more than that. If a president is not married, a friend or a relative may act as first lady. When a woman is elected president, a husband, friend, or relative may fill this role. As first lady?
First lady.
Every 4 years, Americans vote in a presidential election. Like this year, any American citizen who is 18 or older can vote, including presidential candidates.
There's Barack Obama casting his vote. And there's all the voters. Who do you think Barack Obama voted for? And there's William H. Taft casting his vote.
A ballot, ballot, in case you didn't know how to say it, it's not ball-ot, is a list of people who want to be president. Voters in each of the 50 states mark a ballot to make their choice.
That there's a ballot. Fly Guy, you don't have to vote. That election's already done.
The candidate who wins the election moves into the White House with his or her family. The previous president moves out.
Go on, get out of here! You've been evicted!
That there's the Clinton family moving into the White House while the Bush family moves out and goes back to Texas.
All of the presidents have had their portraits painted. Many portraits hang in the White House.
William H. Harrison was president for only 32 days. Huh. Is that what the current president looks like?
President Washington chose the location of the country's new capital city. It was named in his honor.
George Washington lived in New York City while he was president.
There was a contest to design the president's house. In July 1792, a builder named James Hoban won the contest. In 1800, President John Adams and his wife Abigail were the first family to move in. They lived there for just 5 months. Ugh, and then he had to move out again? I hate moving. In 1814, British soldiers set fire to the White House. Where was security then? First Lady Dolly Madison saved a painting from the burning building. It took 3 years to rebuild the house.
Dolly Madison saved this painting of George Washington, our first president of the United States.
Some people think the White House got its name after the fire, but that is not true. The White House has always been painted white. It takes 570 gallons of paint to cover the outside of the building, including the east and west wings. No, not your wings, Fly Guy. For all you painters out there, imagine taking on that job. For years, people simply called it the White House. President Theodore Roosevelt made the name official in 1901. He even added it to his stationery.
My dear Mr. Dunbar, I am touched that you should have written me from your sick bed. I appreciate the poem. As a token of my regard, will you accept the accompanying 2 volumes of my speeches? With best wishes, believe me, sincerely yours, Theodore Roosevelt.
When the White House was first built, it was much smaller. In 1902, President Theodore Roosevelt built an office west of the main house. It was a quiet place for him to work, away from his 6 children. Man, I have 3 and that's crazy enough. This new section became known as the West Wing.
That there is President Roosevelt and his family. And that's the West Wing, underneath all that snow.
In 1909, President Taft built the first Oval Office. Why is it called Oval Office? Because it's oval. Today's Oval Office was built in 1934 and is still the President's office. The Oval Office has 4 exits. 2 of the doors are hidden and blend into the walls. Well, great, now everybody knows that secret too.
The President sits there.
Throughout the year, the White House hosts many special events. The Easter egg roll is the largest event. I bet it would go good with some soy sauce. Children race across the lawn, pushing hard-boiled eggs with spoons. Really, the simplest things entertain people. Why don't they just play soccer? Each November, the president saves 1 turkey from becoming Thanksgiving dinner. This is called a pardon. The turkey lives the rest of its life on a farm. How exciting. The president leads 2 special holiday ceremonies. The lighting of the national Christmas tree and the lighting of the national, Hanukkah menorah. Today, the White House has 132 rooms and 35 bathrooms. That's a lot of places to sit and unload. I bet every single president has made it a point to go to every single bathroom. There are 4 floors, a basement, and a sub-basement. Huh? There are 412 doors, 147 windows, 28 fireplaces, 8 staircases, and 3 elevators. Such wonderful facts.
Up to 140 people can eat dinner in this room. Man, I don't even have 140 friends. I barely even have 10 friends. The Situation Room. How are you supposed to know which situation goes in there? This soundproof basement room is the President's Command Center. People work here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The President joins them when there is a national emergency.
Big house.
In the East Room, this is the largest room in the White House. 7 weddings and a prom have been held here. Who the heck had a prom at the White House? And that there's Lyndon B. Johnson signing the Voting Rights Act in the East Room.
The White House isn't just a place to work. The president has fun there, too. Not all presidents are boring. There's a 46-seat movie theater, a bowling alley, a golf putting green, a swimming pool, and a tennis court. President Obama painted lines on the tennis court to use it as a basketball court. That's my man! That's my jam! Slam dunk. Many children have lived and played in the White House. President Lincoln's son, Tad, once let 2 goats pull him around the house. President Carter's daughter, Amy, roller skated at the White House. And President Kennedy's son, John Jr., often played under his dad's desk.
Well, just another secret exposed to the world. There is a secret door in the desk.
Lots of pets have lived in the White House, too. More than 100 dogs have lived there. The White House has even had alligators. President Hoover's son had 2 pet alligators that liked to crawl around outdoors. And it has been said that President John Quincy Adams had a house guest who brought a live alligator to stay at the White House. President Theodore Roosevelt's kids had a pony, bears, a hyena, a pig, a macaw, cats, dogs, snakes, a badger, kangaroo rats, a flying squirrel, guinea pigs, and more. Oh, like 2 of those things are pets.
No pet flies.
Well, I guess not.
President Kennedy's daughter, Caroline, had a pony named Macaroni. Yankee Doodle went to town riding on a pony, stuck a feather in his head and called it Macaroni. Is that where that comes from? Some say the president and his or her family aren't the only ones who live at the White House. Ghosts might live there too. It was already Halloween. The ghost of Abigail Adams has been spotted hanging laundry in the East Room. Well, she can come to my house anytime. President Taft's staff. Try saying that three times as fast as you can. President Taft's staff said they saw her. The most famous ghost is that of President Lincoln. People say that his ghost haunts the second floor and his former bedroom. I'm not sleeping in there. His ghost knocks on doors and sometimes stands at a window. Huh. He probably left something there. Celebrities visit the White House. Cool. Famous singer Elvis Presley visited President Nixon. He looks so excited. Pope John Paul II was the first pope to visit the famous house. Gryffindor? Queen Elizabeth II has visited the White House many times, beginning in 1957 when she made her first state visit to America. President Jefferson opened the White House to visitors, so anyone can tour the president's home for free. I'll do anything for free. Even Fly Guy has visited.
My fellow Americans. You landed on the president's forehead?
I am famous.
And then you did it again at the vice president debate. It was such an honor to visit the president's house.
Buzz told Fly Guy.
Maybe we'll work there one day.
Yes. Buzz and Fly Guy could not wait for their next field trip. Vote for Fly Guy!
Well, I know who's getting my vote.
President Taft's staff is there. There they are. President Taft's staff. President Taft's staff. President's have stash. President Taft's staff. President Taft's staff. President Taft's staff. President Taft's staff.